In the last session, session 11, we talked about platform-driven economy. And we also understood that India Stack is trying to drive India towards one nation, one platform. Let us have a look at the practical implementation of the same in this session, session 12, which is India Enterprise Framework, which will give us a framework to catalyze the possibility of one nation, one platform. So, in this session, we would talk about what is India Enterprise Architecture, which is abbreviated beautifully as India but spelled with E. We would also look at objectives of India, this particular India with E. We would look at structure and principles of India. We would look at government implementation strategy for India and also understand what is the reference framework for India. The need for India came because there was an essential requirement to create services which were citizen-centric, outcome-focused, standard, reusable and integrated across the department, services, etc. The whole point of India is that service may be redesigned taking a whole of government view, disregarding the departmental barriers, and a common integrated and multi-purpose forms may be designed in a similar manner so that citizens have a wonderful experience of using such platforms. The primary requirement was also to assist various government organizations such as ministries, state departments and other local departments to adopt a structured and formalized approach in developing their enterprise architecture. Therefore, India with E was advocated. The whole aim of India with E is to bridge the need of providing a long-term vision for one government experience, which we call as one nation, one platform. The goal of governance defined by SDGs are converted into objectives. The objectives of governance are converted into programs, projects, and schemes. The schemes are implemented in various verticals or sectors, which are handled by several departments. The departments provide services. A business reference model is required to define these services properly so that the objective, type, category, priority, and service level are understood. Then they are enhanced by an approach which we studied in third session of transformation, but this is at service level where a lot of change management issues and re-engineering is done. Then it is related to service delivery where identification of channels and service providers and beneficiaries are done. And finally, measurement matrices are inbuilt for proper analysis of output, outcome and net impact on the economy. This is total business reference model which has been the driving force for designing India with E. This architecture also includes data analytics. It also understands the practice of organizing logic so that IT infrastructure is maintained properly. It also insists on using technology for undertaking services in a manner so that they function properly and satisfactorily. It focuses on storing and collecting data, selling and implementing the good, and providing customer services to the satisfaction of the citizen, and ensures a clear collaboration across disciplines in an enterprise fashion. With this background, we can formulate the objectives of India with E as number one, providing guidance in the development of enterprise architecture across the departments using service as the building block. It also provides the capturing possibilities of key elements of this architecture and explaining the interrelationships between them. It also provides the means for architecturing the governance by enabling a proper audit process for measuring the output, outcome and contribution to economy. It also enables the adoption of standards based on common understanding that cuts across the departments and ministries at the service level. Last but not the least, India with E provides documentation and sharing of architecture best practices which could be recorded for explicit and implicit benefits. if I have to look at government enterprise architecture within our country, I would again divide it in very simple categories of national level, state level, panchayat level, organization level and domain level. At national level, State Bank of India is using India Enterprise Architecture. At state level, we have wonderful initiatives of Shillong Enterprise Architecture, Meghalaya Enterprise Architecture, as well as Andhra Pradesh e-Pragati system, which we would have covered in previous sessions. At panchayat level, we already have Panchayat Enterprise Architecture Framework, which is also called as PEAF and is being looked into by NIC. At organization level, we did hear about GSTN, we heard about Aadhaar, we heard about GEM, and also we have Passport Seva Kendra, which could be looked as an enterprise-wide implementation of one platform and one service. In terms of domain, we have reusable components of University Enterprise Architecture Framework. We have State Public Service Commission Architecture Framework. We have Land Hub Enterprise Architecture, all being developed by NIC. How is this handled? This is handled or defined by India with E, that consists of 8 reference models and framework key principles. These reference models include performance reference model, business reference model, application reference model, data reference model, technology reference model, integration reference model, security reference model, and last but not the least, architecture governance reference model. Each of these reference models, which the 8 of them, have various key principles which would be looked into by us in our class. Broadly, we can understand that the performance reference model provides a uniform mechanism to measure the effectiveness and efficiency of outcome assessment. The second, business reference model, focuses on the business entities such as functions and services that are required to fulfill the vision of India with E and permits integration of services and re-engineering of them as the core focus. In application reference model, the main aim is to provide a foundation of function and automate these services using the business reference model. In the data reference model, as the name indicates, collaboration and sharing of information is defined. The same model helps us to identify, discover, describe, manage and protect the data to be shared and to be reused within the various levels of the organization. Coming to the next layer out of these 8 is technology reference model. The technology reference model is built upon the ICT based applications to produce the cost effective framework that will permit digital collaboration and association. The next one is integration reference model, where the key objective is to include transparent systems that could be achieved by integration so that the different layers of government can work and collaborate together. Security reference model is a very important model because security is a key aspect in terms of digital connectivity and use of internet and other services. Therefore, this model provides best practices for security of India with E and all the digital assets which constitute this revolution. The last is architecture governance reference model that establishes and lays down the foundation design of India and its principles with the responsibility that the processes and the structural relationships are built in a whole framework to align it to the business vision. It's very important for us to also understand at this point that when we started our session in session 1, we referred to a key aspect of digital transformation of governance, and that is called as agility. Now, the whole purpose of India would be defeated in case we do not inculcate the concept of agility. Therefore, India framework agile also is incorporated, and India framework and agile practices have been harmonized together in what is called as Agile India, India with E. It simplifies the understanding of India and promotes the widespread adoption of it across the various layers of federal structure. It is trying to recommend these 8 models so that just enough architecture. That means an agile, a lean and mean architecture is implemented, and this kind of agility could be implemented not just in greenfield projects but also in brownfield projects. So as you would have understand, using all these building blocks of India stack and India enterprise architecture, later we would do standards also, which are very important for interoperability. We are moving closer and closer to our main goal or vision of one nation, one platform. The whole purpose of developing such reference models like India or DSS or other aspects of layers of India stack is to ensure availability, accessibility, affordability and adaptability of services. So that brings us to the next very important component of one nation, one platform, which is Digital Service Standard or DSS. The purpose of DSS to ensure interoperability across this 8 reference model. Now this is the next milestone for us in digital transformation journey of governance, and we would see you in session 13 to talk about DSS. Till then, thank you. Jai Hind.